So the helping a better person. Now, a lot of people are struggling in life. They have a lot of issues. I started last week about the discourse. The number one thing in becoming a better version of your life is to become a better person. The norm in life is that people prosper when you are okay. When people know you, you have integrity. When people know you, you are a person of truth. We cannot undermine what about the splendor of God's majesty, but we have an honor to pay. You have a duty to pay. Our God is immaculate in character. The norm is that business will go better when you are a better person. If I was selfish, look at Onesimus. He was not profitable from the world, but not from the world, profitable. You may say that somebody is crooked, that somebody was crooked in real world, but that is the exception, that is not enough. That is what? It's not enough. There are fraudulent people that have admiration for what I call the dumb parts. Yes, they are conscious of it. But that is the exception. That is not the rule. I started teaching on the juice code. The essence of what I'm teaching is to enhance your economic capacity, is to enhance your revenue capacity. I said so many things last week that your imagination, what did I say? You have forgotten the picture. In the book of Genesis chapter 11, he said, there is nothing that you can imagine that they will not come to pass. You need to work on your imagination. I said imagination is having to bring into existence what is not existing. Imagination is to provide solution to a particular problem. We have so many things like that looking for solution. That is what we call imagination. I said watching television will do what? We diminish your imagination. We diminish your what? But reading book will enhance your imagination. Reading book, it will make your memory become copious. As advice, praise the name of the Lord. Your memory become copious as advice. When you read book, I'm just advising some of those who started last week. I spoke about pessimism. What did I call it? Pessimism. The law of pessimism. How do you have life? Sorry, law of optimism. Sorry. What are the, can anybody take optimism to better? This fact is, I'm not even going to have a let me forget about it. I'm talking about becoming a better person. You want to function of life to become better. Overwhelming majority of people succeed when they are good people. Praise the Lord. Our athlete will not be good. The footballer will not be good because the athlete will not be able to ball. But not so in business. If a lawyer is coming to you, you are patronizing a lawyer, medical doctor. You are not interested in the suit that's attended. Am I saying the truth? Whether you are going to Harvard, some of you have been going to Harvard Law School, did you know where the university medical school went to? Did you know? Answer me. They don't even know. How are you going to Ghana? Do you know the medical school they attended? People are not interested. They want doctors that will give them go. They want doctors that are very competent. They want if I'm going to mention that, I'm sure I'm becoming a better person. Becoming what? Only someone becomes a better person. You become a better person. They are not interested. You want to tell them, I made first class. Even if I have anyone in the world, if the person is not going to go to school. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. If you want to enhance national borders, brothers and sisters, you must do business with individuals that you know. Who you can trust? You cannot bamboozle people at all times. What did they say? What did they say? You cannot bamboozle what at all times. There is a conjunction between business and business. There is a conjunction between what? Business and business. You can bamboozle people at all times. No, 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 no. There is a conjunction. the great business of all, and this is praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. The world is full of people with skills. It is your business that will build reputation and to connect with people. And what did I say last? Which is your most money-making order? Can anybody tell me? Can you tell me your most money? Yes? Your mouth is the most money-making order. Is the man we used to sell. Is the man we used to negotiate. Isn't it? What I thought, and I asked you to go and walk on your mouth. As a preacher, I must walk on my mouth. To reflect, to preach, so that people can be what? Empowered, people can be inspired. Money, and you do, or on contact, they open your bigger hole. And on top of that, you die, that's it. Am I correct? Praise the Lord, you know. That is, if you speak something bad, they will slap you. If you say something good, they will give you gifts. Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. I know I'm correct. You see, when doctors give a sense of optimism, they give a sense of hope about the condition, you patronize them. You feel good, you feel at home. Praise the name of the Lord. Go to that. What did I say? Becoming a better person is very important. Then work on your emotions. What did I say? If you want to become a better person, everybody will go to the book of Romans chapter 7, verse 15. Romans chapter 7, verse 15. I read. Romans chapter 7, verse 15. For that which I do, I allow not. For what I will, that I do I not, but what I hate, that do I. Underline that. What are your what? Emotions. The Bible says, the angry I see not. I don't allow the sun to set upon your word anger, not those decisions. I'll tell you. Now, I said, number two, this must avoid calamity and calumny. Avoid what? Calamity and what? They have the same ecological base in English. I'm not to say that. There are people that are controlled by their body, emotions, and what? Brain. That one we need to what? Calamity and what? Calumny. But they can also be invasive. Once you are controlled by your brain, your emotion and body, it leads to what? Prosperity, royalty. Royalty and what? Success. Everybody, your body, when you want to sleep, you sleep. When you want to eat, you eat. You are being controlled by your word, by your emotions. You need to work on that. Praise the name of the Lord. You need to regulate your emotions. Your emotion can be controlled. It's a big secret to your success. If you can control your emotion. As the food was cooking up and down in the house yesterday, you know, they said, when are you going to exercise? I am fasting. Praise the name of the Lord. I said, what? I was fasting. The Lord did not spoke to me to fast. Praise the name of the Lord. I know I didn't tell you yesterday was my birthday. And what I did was to do what? A colloquium. To organize a lecture on COVID-19. Scarce commodities. Water and what? Sanitation. Then a lecturer from the University of KwaZulu, South Africa. No. He gave us a lecture through the world Zoom. Shout hallelujah. That's how I want to celebrate my birthday. To impact on development. To impact on what? Yes, I am part of the society to bring solution to what is happening in the world. Shout hallelujah. So it has started. This year, maybe next year, we invite you also to you, okay? He said, Pastor, I'm going to do that for local on investing and development. Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Now, I am talking about look. A lot of people, you need to work on their emotions. The eighth commandment is don't steal, isn't it? But the tenth commandment is what? Don't convert your neighbor. The tenth commandment is saying don't do what? It's talking about working on your emotions. When you are fantasizing what you don't need, what is not your own, you need to work on your emotion. Anger, you need to work on it. Praise the name of the Lord. You need to deal with your emotions. If it is fear, stop. Fear can stop you with your destiny. Fear is very destructive, very destructive and contagious. That thing you are afraid of, do it. There are some people that are afraid of doing danger for yourself. Do it, nothing will happen to you. There are some people that are afraid of waking up at night and write. Wake up at night and do it. There are some people that are afraid of selling particular product to marketing. Rise up and do it. Praise the name of the Lord. Gideon was going about with a 30,000 army, but because of fear, they were reduced. Courage does not mean that it's not fear. It means you know how to manage your fear. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, when we are going to start, like I said, that book of Romans chapter 7 verse 15. He said, those things that you do not want to do, those are the things what you want to do. Okay. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, he said, look at it. Praise the Lord. People are listening to us in various places within and outside Nigeria. Now, he said, the things I want to do, those are the things you don't want to do. We call it the law of spiritual gravity. What do we call it? If you want to be a better person, deal with the law of spiritual gravity, or what you call entropy. What do you call what? Romans chapter 7 verse 5, 15, sorry. Then, the book of Genesis chapter 1, verse 2. The Bible says, God created the earth, and everything was what? What happened when the earth was created? It was woman, it was homeless. That is what you call what? Entropy. Or what you call what? Spiritual gravity, everything was created and turbulent. Now, let me tell you what is entropy. When you want to start a program that will change your financial destiny, brothers and sisters, when you want to change a program that will enhance your money-making capacity, when you want to embark on a program that will make sure that you advance in life, what will come in, we discover is that there are certain things that will put you back on. That is what God, the law of what? Spiritual gravity or entropy. You want to lose weight? The spiritual gravity will say no. That you have to eat. But so and so and so forth. You want to stop smart? The spiritual gravity say no. I am not out there to do. Praise the Lord. Everybody knows. So smart, I say no. I was in my room lying down, coming with my girl, my neighbor, thinking about God. Things in the world are not the way they are. If I complain, if you have been complaining for a long time, let us see a solution for you. And if you don't complain, 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 party, party, party. We know solution. You want what? I'm going to talk about what I call high quality person and low quality people. It's when that one should shape your destiny. When I get to that place, I'm a high quality person. I am a high quality person. You can decide to be a high quality person. It doesn't matter. You can decide to be a high quality person. I now know, thank God, the Lord God forced me to all the social media. I now recognize that it's so powerful. People can admire what we are doing here and there and so on and so forth. It encourages me a lot. You can pray for people and they receive it in a mental kinds of places without the physical touch. The spiritual gravity and those things that pull you back when you decide to enhance your financial capacity. You want to enhance your economic activity. You want to expand your economic base. The artists who cannot do that to you. No. Nobody said we are not a prosper. Nobody said you are what I am, do well. They call them spiritual gravity. You need to live with them. Do not destroy them. Spiritual gravity are the forces that push you in the opposite direction of what you want to do. I want to become members of the prayer warrior. It's not posting now from next Sunday. If you are coming, make sure you join the group. Either prayer or evangelism. If you know that God is actually your father, it is incumbent. It is my force that you join the group. What does your father want without God? Don't be a best woman. Don't come to God's financial and general ministry and want best and mean nothing for God. The spirit of spiritual gravity is what we put that person. What is spiritual gravity? We must deal with it because it is destructive and totally sabotage your efforts. You can do what? Every time you want to learn how to drive, but something is moving you down. You want to learn how to do something, but your spiritual gravity is saying no. You must deal with what? Spiritual gravity. Spiritual gravity or entropy. It has the tendency to obstruct the progress you desire to better and improve your life. It has to, you know, to obstruct it. Stand at the word of your progress. You must recognize the horse and the rider. That is the rider that controls the horse. The rider controls what? I can't tell you. If that's a good project, book written project, has gone into entropy, you must go and pick it right now. It is the rider that controls the horse, not the horse that is controlling the rider. Praise the name of the Lord. The rider must tell the horse where to go. The boss of those disciples will discover. Praise the name of the Lord. We must do with what? Spiritual entropy. Spiritual entropy. We must discern within us. The principle of entropy is something we must deal with. No, we must deal with it. We must not allow that to destroy us. And if you are afraid, I said, fear can paralyze and destroy you. Make sure you deal with that fear in your life. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Close your eyes. You are going to present, oh Lord, my Father. I cannot hear you. Help me to improve in my life. In the name of Jesus, open my eyes to that. Help me to improve right now. In the name of Jesus, help me to improve right now. In the name of Jesus, ask God, you want to improve. You want to get to improve right now. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray. In the name of Jesus, yes, yes, improve your life. Improve right now. In the name of Jesus, ask God that you want to improve my right now. In your life, in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Praise the name of the Lord. I'm speaking about what? Becoming a better person. What people emotions deal with what? Spiritual world, gravity. Praise the name of the Lord. Do you want to become a better person? You must address your weaknesses. You must do what? You must address your weaknesses. Very, very important. And let's go up to the book of Proverbs chapter 24, verse 10. Proverbs chapter 24. It says, if thou find enough capacity, thy strength is small. Now, your weakness is the area where you are easily overcome. Where you are easily overcome is your weakness. You need to deal with it. It is the area where you are very soft, where you are too soft and efficient. Deal with it. Your weakness is the area where you have no resistance. And your moral strength is very weak. They are supposed to want to do teaching. They are very weak. So many, for so many people, they will not join our teaching. And through that teaching, God has done a lot. I can tell you, healing, spectacular healing, God has done it through that teaching. Restoration, God has done that teaching. Your angel's weakness is your legion of flaws. F-L-A-O-S. Your weakness will weaken your destiny. Your weakness can destroy your honor. Your weakness can hinder your promotion and testimony. Your weakness will strengthen the enemy. When you are supposed to be doing preaching and you are sleeping, well, we are not meeting this morning now. Instead of you to put another by level, then you are sleeping, then the enemy comes to form, strengthen them. They will bring Buguru, they will bring Shishi, then they will bring Kate. Then they go and bring one for okra soup with chili. Then you eat everything. Then you don't feel the person with power. You don't wake up. Your weakness is due to the enemy. Your life can become better. Your life can be what? You can become a better version of yourself. But this is personal sin. Spiritually, God is waiting for you. Your weakness will strengthen the enemy. You always forget. It will strengthen the enemy. It will destroy your integrity. It will destroy your focus. Your weakness will rubbish your shipments. It will rubbish your shipments. So you must, if you want to become a better version, you must walk upon your weakness.
Now, if you go to the book of Genesis
chapter 6, verse number 12, you will see that the Amalekite was a descendant of Esau. Isn't it? Isn't it? My message on wiping out the Amalekite, go and look at YouTube or what to call it, Facebook, you see it here. I specifically did a message here. You don't look at it. Let's go to Genesis chapter 36, verse 12. Don't worry. Mascapo, soca, para, mascapo, lava. Genesis chapter 36. Oh, my. We have a lot to cover. Genesis chapter 36. Verse 12. And then, and Timon was occupied to Eliphaz, his son. And she turned to Eliphaz, Amalek. Amalek. Praise the name of the Lord. These were the sons of Adam, Esau's son. So, Amalek was a grandchild of what? Esau. Notice. So that we don't want to deal with what we call a better fashion. Say, I shall become a better fashion. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, Amalek's men were going to wipe out the Israel. He was just kind of a blessing for many, many generations. You know, the Amalekite Israel has given them the charge, the command that they should wipe out Israel. Because Esau and Jacob, they were what? Twin brothers, isn't it? Can you remember?
Yes.
No, I just want to know the Bible. Like, this is not a prayer action. You should be able to discuss Bible with boldness. Praise the Lord. So, Amalek is a spiritual nation. Amalek that wanted to destroy the children of Israel, he never cared. He was dealing with them because of the bad man. What was there? God appeared to Jacob was not a worry. When they wanted to bless Jacob, one of the issues he mentioned was his brother Esau. For God to not worry about it. Jacob said to God, with an angry, even understand, you promised me everything, but my brother Esau is a big threat. But God promised me security. Praise the Lord. God promised what? Security. So Esau suddenly turned Amalek to destroy future Israel. If there are power that have destroyed your finances, if there are power that have destroyed your business and your job, Lord, you need to do it for the powers of Amalek. Amalek was always ready to die for the cause of destroy what? The children of Israel. Any power that want to die simply because of your prosperity, that is what we call you Amalek. You call what? You want to know? You call it what? You see now the synopsis. Tell us to the book of Esther. If I follow the shout, hallelujah. You cannot become a better person without dealing with the Amalekite in your life. These are the forces of darkness that want to scatter you, they want to destroy you. This Friday we are fasting. We are doing what? I cannot hear you. The Amalek was on the principle, what I call the principle of self-interest. He did not recognize his essential destruction. Destruction. If a nation is attacking a nation, and this gets so bad, you engage the spiritual issue for not Amalekites. They are ready to destroy. They are ready to do what? If a particular nation is attacking a particular nation and they want to destroy it, they retreat, not with the spirit of Amalekite. Something happened in May 1940. The army knew they were struck in Belgium. Okay? About 39,000 British soldiers. They came back home. Then we struggled was the president then. He said to the parliament, we thank God for the leader of our soldiers. They started to keep pressing the witness from the destroyer that they wanted to be defeated. Then they went back. Now, when you discover that the enemy is abandoning you, then you need to move back and re-strategize. They do what? To re-strategize. But not like Amman. Amman is an example of Amalek. I mean, so it's from the tribe of Amalek, and they are ready to do what? To destroy. Amalek is not a biological nation, but a spiritual nation in every state of history. Amalek is not a biological nation, but what? A spiritual nation in what? In any state of what? History. They are in your life. I remember, I said, leader, you know, in Sanderson, Mr. Amalek, out of respect to the children of the nation, out of confession, praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, something happened. And that will help you and so that to get the Jesus to you. You see, Germany and Russia, they enter the children of, not attacking. That they are not going to attack each other. And what was happening? Because Russia, very powerful, and then Germany. But what do you understand in those days? They were supposed to not attack each other. But something happened, they don't know about that Germany was about to attack Britain. But Germany mistakenly went and attacked Russia. What in this kingdom that's about the Russia? And that was why they started fighting each other. I pray your stubborn enemies of your next level, they shall keep themselves in the name of Jesus. Yeah. I say they shall keep themselves in the name of Jesus. Yeah. I cannot hear your amen. Yeah. Now, you see, that 1941, when David decided to invade Russia, he ran into a problem. But then, instead of trying to go back, they went further. There was no time. As soon as they were prepared, they still went ahead and fought. What happened? The people that died by splinter was no more than people that died through the bullet. Millions of soldiers were frozen by winter. Only people died through the Russian bullet. I pray your enemy shall be frozen to death in the mighty name of Jesus. Ever never give up. There are power that will never give up over your life. One word for that to change. Killing the Jews was the most important thing to the Amalekite. If I was an Amalek, and that's what I'm talking about. And that was why I gave those up against the children of what? Easter. Praise the name of the Lord. If you look at the book of Obadiah, the book of Obadiah, you will see that Esau is related to the gods. This is what? So that we can find the enemies of your God. Your new fashion. Let's look at the book of Obadiah. Obadiah, are you there? Obadiah has only one chapter. The vision of Obadiah does say the word of God concerning Edom. We have had a rumor from the Lord that an ambassador is sent among the Edom. Arise and let us rise up in battle. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Now I move to verses. How are these things of Esau such up? How are these things of Esau? All the men of the confederation are brought him to the border. The men that are peace with him and the city are prepared against him. They that eat their bread have laid a wound under him that is not understanding him. Shall man not without the said Lord even destroy the wise men out of Edom and understanding out of the mouth of Esau? And the mighty men of Tamar shall be displayed to the men, that every one of the mouth of Esau may be covered by the slaughter. Praise the name of the Lord. They will be covered by the slaughter. Note it very well. Now, if you look back, he said, for the violence against thy brother Jacob shall cover thee, and thou shalt come up ever. In that day, thou students on the other side, in the day that the strangers carry away captives his forces, and foreigners enter into his gate, and task force upon Jerusalem, even thou was as one thou ex. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, if you look at that place, it's talking about what? Esau, and we need to understand this properly. Now, if you look at that, the Amalekites, they did not retreat in attacking the children of Israel. If you look at Obadiah, you will see that Esau is very related to the Lord. And there are only two cities on the planet of the 36 degree east, Moscow and Jerusalem. I have said that in the history. If you look at the Bible very well, you see that issue is very related, mentioned to the things as far as the Lord is concerned. I said, there are only two cities on the parallel of longitude, city great east, and two cities are what? Moscow and what? Jerusalem. Listen, in the north is Moscow, in the east is what? Jerusalem. This one was born with what color? Anybody tell me? Red, isn't it? What we call the people of Russians? Eh? What we call them? The red. What is the flag of Russia? Yes? What is the flag? What is the color of Russian flag? Eh? Can you tell it? Praise the Lord, Lord. Our sisters. What is the color of Russian flag? Red! Praise the name of the Lord. Red! Praise the name of the Lord. You can see when they persecuted the Russian Jews. It was that spirit of Amalekite that he came. Hitler and Germany throughout the 20th century also came and attacked them. But God said, don't worry. I said, Hitler and Russia, they signed a non-aggression pact in July 1939, before the war, for 10 years. They said the Russians and Germany would not fight each other. But in May 1940, one of the greatest military disasters happened. They wanted to attack England, okay? America was not joining them there. They were not joining the war that was going on. But unfortunately, it was hard to see what was about. Germany went and attacked the Russians, and that was how God delivered the people of England. Brothers and sisters, there are certain things we need to know like this. God's word is not, God's word is the roadmap of history. If you want to be a better version, you need the words of God. The word of God, I promise, anyone that rises up against the Christian, anyone that calls it is at the cross, we call it anti-Semitism. So the word of God is the roadmap to history. You must hold on to the word of God. It is not computer. How long you move is already history. So you must visually deal with the man that in your life. It will be spiritual God of spirit, but if you want to be a better version. This is the spiritual warfare side of what I'm talking about right now. Then the last segment which I'm talking about, pray the name of the Lord, is do you want to be a high quality person or a low quality person? That is the last segment. Write it down. Do you want to become a low quality person or a high quality person? This is where we stop and pray and go. Now, in becoming a better version of yourself, you must aspire to be a high quality person. I mentioned about a better person, the law of mutual gravity, deal with your emotions, avoid calamity and calumny, and what deal with what? The Amalekite your life. And talk about now, you must be a high quality person. You want to be a better version. And I'm going to spend time on this so that you will go and take action. As for the name, combine what I thought last week, combine with this one. And if I'm not here last week, go to our Facebook, go to our YouTube, then you will see those messages there. By the special grace of our God, our website will be out very, very, very soon. Okay? Maybe my next week will have lots of our website. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
One of the benefits of being in a economically strong society is that a economically strong society is our military strength. And that is why in Nigeria, this business is very well. You need this message. Because our economy is very weak. Our economy is what? It's very weak. But what do you do in a weak economy? I'm not saying it's everybody that is a strong economy that are making it. No, I'm not saying that. There are people that are strong over there in America. I told about the vision that the black race we are talking about, they have been free, right, what call it? Have never abolished slavery. But the spirit of slavery is still with them over there. So if you are going to better pray against the spirit of slavery, I'm sure people are there, even their English pronunciation is not doing well, and affecting them to get into it. This has not been so bad. Even the black, what we call it, the red India, the original, the of America, they are very difficult to post economically and socially. They are doing only two drums. Because there's some fanatic. I told people in this hour, it's the spirit of indifference. So many people are there, the spirit of indifference. They don't have what? They don't take life serious. I can come to church every night, I can pass it. You have to take responsibility for your life if you don't want to become an inability. You have to take responsibility for your life if you don't want to become what? An inability. Being a brand of coming in your life. You don't make up come from it. Take charge of your life today. Take charge. Whatever anyone else, take charge of your life. Let the heavens go. That you want to pass. Because you are coming to this one at once. Take charge. That you are going to make impact. I think some people, when they are living their life, I'm going to talk about some of the situation in America and so on and so forth. My eyes are becoming open. You know, when you are dealing with people directly, you can see what is happening. I said, economically strong nations, they are strong military. Without economic strength, your military strength will be rendered what? Weak. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. You see, one of the reasons why American law is better than what they don't know how to fight guerrilla warfare. The Chinese are very tough, and they defeated them in that war. Now, in our journey of life, you get a particular situation that you want to improve your economic well-being. If you want your situation to improve, raise up your hand. Praise the name of the Lord. God bless you. Now, it's also possible for some strong economy to have a very weak community base. If you look at the population of a state like Lagos, it's more than twice the population of my state, or three times the state. If you look at the population of Georgia, in America, it's more than 2 times the population of Rhode Island. And the GDP of what we call Georgia is more than 8 times of the Rhode Island. In other words, the total product that you produce, that is what we call about what? GDP. Now, how do I improve myself in an economically weak nation like this? We have been talking about US, which is very good. The population of US is about 130 million. And then, their GDP is very, very high. They put like, what do you call it, Eastern, just 5 million. But GDP per capita is very high. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, the question is this. How do I make myself a high-quality person in this kind of environment? I want to list it very, very, very well. Because you need economic power as an individual. If you cannot do anything about it, you have to establish something about it right now. Number one thing, you need what I call genuine and not inflated education. What did I call it? What did I call it? The illiterate in this generation is not going to cannot read or write. You need to not inflated PhD and CPhD. No. When we are talking about genuine qualifications, we are talking about people that are very good. You have good grammar. It's not something that we say to work or to shop. People that can speak fluently. When they're calling for Italian, you can speak fluently. We must have genuine education. Praise the name of the Lord. Number two, connectivity with the people. What do they call it? People should get together. Praise the name of the Lord. Somebody you don't know cannot recommend you. People must get together and cross-pollinate. People must cross-pollinate. If you are a sales professional, for you to sell a particular product, you need to talk to people. And that is where you will be able to communicate very well. A lot of people that are talking about, by the time they speak English, they put you off. We are not talking about inflated communication, but what? Genuine communication. I also spoke about connectivity. If you don't connect, you cannot be able to make money. It's when you connect with people, either to one way or another, that is when money can come to a win. There is a good difference between high quality people and what? Low quality people. It is not about bank account. It is not about color. No, that is not what I am talking about. Oh, low quality or high quality people. No. But in terms of what we are talking about, praise the name of the Lord. You will do well financially when you have the trust and the, you know, what I call the confidence of more people. You can do well. Quality of people, we are talking about wisdom. The Bible says wisdom is the principal thing with what? With all wisdom, what? Get it. Are you wise at all? When I'm talking about wisdom, I am not talking about intelligent quotient. Intelligent quotient is how quickly your brain can process things. That is what's called IQ. That's what's called what? IQ. How quickly your brain can process something. A person with 130 IQ will be able to pass through a problem quickly than a person with what? 90 intelligent quotient. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Wisdom is for you to understand how the world around you is working. That is what you call what? Wisdom. In spite of the prestige, in spite of the academic qualifications, men and women of the same profession, they may not be the same in terms of wisdom. A high quality people, they have inbuilt culture of self-discipline. Inbuilt culture of what? Self-discipline. They organize themselves, they have schedule. You don't need to put them to do something. They are self-motivated. A high-quality person that what? Inbuilt sense of what? Self-discipline. He says, I will be there before you. You will see the person get there. A high-quality person, they are disciplined to keep their word from what they want. A high-quality person, brothers and sisters, they call what you call BDP, which I mentioned. Brain, emotions are what? Body. Not body, emotions are what? Brain. Praise the Lord. A high-quality person, they defy gratification. There are people they want for no, give me no. Just test them. They defy gratification. Praise the Lord. High-quality people, they are impulse are under control. Under what? The impulse is under control. Everything they want, you know, impulse buys. When you buy what you do not plan for, that's what you call impulse buy in commerce. Am I correct? Commerce is an impulse buy. A high quality person, the impulse is under control. It's under control. A high quality person, they are not violent in argument. They are not violent in argument. At all. They are not violent in argument. They are under control. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Brothers and sisters, the things that make people a high quality person is not money. It's not a qualification. But these things that we have mentioned. Adam Smith in his Theory of Moral Sentiment, he itemized some of these things. Also, John Stuart Mills. In his turn of utilitarians, the intervention of these things. You need these things to provide a better version. Brothers and sisters, when you want to be social capital, you want to improve your empathetic capacity, work on this adaptation since last week. I want to see at a very high level. I want to see your empathetic capacity enhanced. I want to see your economic base expanded. I want to see your economic life improve. It's possible. What did I say? You have the money to pay. It's possible. It's possible. Combine the message of today with language message and see what will happen. As you go, use your imagination. As you go, plan to become a person of you. Be a high quality person. You want to break, but you can't break it. Do it. It's very important. Be a high quality person. Say, I'm a high quality person. You have seen that what I've said is not money, it's not everything right now. For those that think that will bring money, they bring money. Shout hallelujah. Wow, after 11, we started at 9:30. Close your eyes. We shall progress as old as you are. You will never Jesus, I'm not going to be seated.